thought. Perhaps they are passively spread without being questioned. We are taught that some people are more beautiful than others because they possess attractive features which make them desirable. Yet, when I asked my friends what they found attractive in a boy or a girl, they all listed different attributes. Some rebels even mentioned things like humor, kindness, or being trustworthy. So, if our preferences differ that much, why categorize people by the same criteria? And then, we mock those with insecurities we help create by calling them weak. There was a time when it felt really original, it actually wasn't, to use the word potato when describing myself. You know, light brown, yellowish skin, with no outstanding features. About that time, I heard a classmate saying about a girl that she was nothing special, that she had an ugly face. In that moment, something inside me started to boil, the temperature rising and rising, my palms trembling, my cheeks reddening, until I felt the urge to burst out a couple of very expressive words to friendly scold him. But then, I shut my eyes and let it go. Realization had hit me. It was the exact same way I was talking about myself, the same way many people talk about themselves. So why hate him for something I had created? A piece of self was left there. And if that didn't convince you not to be that hard on yourself, then look at your eyes. They are the same as those who've seen your mother for the first time. The same that started differentiating colors. Those eyes are imprinted with the lines that form around your father's eyes and mouth when he smiles. They absorb images which shape your soul. Have you ever said your soul is ugly? I know, it sounds unnatural to do so. Then how can you look in the mirror and say that your eyes are ugly or that you are ugly? Point two. I see. It's because you have dark circles, or short lashes, or a big nose. You see these on your loved ones every single day. Did you ever think they are ugly? Stereotypes carved in our minds, in our teachers' and parents' minds, encourage us to create limitations. Most people think success equals with becoming an engineer, a lawyer, or a doctor. Having a title you can brag about means nothing if, at the end of a workday, you come back home feeling exhausted, even though you get enough rest, unhappy to the brink of depression. What does society tell these people? It's because you haven't got used to it. It's just a phase. It will go away. So basically, if you're unhappy with your life, just wait for the universe to fix it. Among those unhappy with their career choice are people who are discouraged from trying something too big. For example, studying to become an accountant instead of a dentist because your parents think it's safer. And waking up, third year of university, feeling miserable at just 21 years old. True story. Another piece of self was left there. So what if you don't feel like the path your career started on? Think of what makes your heart beat faster and do just that. There are millions of paths available. And let me tell you a secret. You can even create a new one, something no one's ever heard of. And if you are really passionate about that thing, then you will work for it and thrive, for it will be original. Now, I'm not saying that you have to reinvent the wheel or something, but no matter what you choose to do, bring your personal contribution to it. Without authenticity, you will get to a point where you feel trapped in a cage, living someone else's life. You are all spectators here, but do you know what you can't see from that perspective? Your own life. Do not leave yet another piece of self abandoned somewhere for the sake of others, or because you are too scared. Build your concrete. Concrete. A material composed of fine and coarsical stones bound together with a fluid cement, which hardens over time. Take your little stones. The physical aspects you do not like about yourself, the disappointment you experienced, all those bits you felt were lost. Put them on top of the other and create a pile. Can you see it? Good. Now, add a realization of the fact that no one else has the exact same combination of features as you do, the same thoughts and abilities, and that you are never stuck into one place unless you choose to be. Congratulations. Now, you won't have to pick everything up all over again after being confronted with a hardship. Sure, you might chip at the edges, but that will only make your construction more intricate. Now, you are one solid rock.